from News 8 WMTW-TV. This is a News 8 Now update.
You're watching News 8 Now. I'm Shannon Moss.
I'm Norm Karkos. There's a public hearing tonight in Westbrook about the ongoing dispute between Pike Industries, the city, and several businesses near Pike's Spring Street Quarry.
And it comes just a day after IDEX Laboratories made a surprise announcement about its plan for a compromise. News 8's Cam Tran has more from Westbrook.
For months, it's been an ongoing saga between Pike Industries and its neighbors regarding its Spring Street Quarry expansion. Now, one of the companies completely against that expansion is IDEX, their veterinary research company. Just this week, IDEX submitted a letter to the city outlining its compromise, but Pike Industries says that it's really no deal for them at all. IDEX's new proposal calls for a maximum of 6 blasts per year at the Spring Street Quarry and no more than 70,000 tons of rock extracted from the site per year. Now, these levels are far below the compromise Pike issued earlier this month, saying 20 blasts a year will allow them to keep their business afloat. Now, the mayor has put together a steering committee to find a common ground between these companies, and before they make a recommendation to the Westbrook City Council, they're putting together a public hearing tonight. That hearing will be at 6 o'clock at the Westbrook High School Auditorium in Westbrook. Cam Tran, News 8.
Laid off workers who made blankets at West Point Home in Biddeford now eligible for more aid from the federal government. Congresswoman Shelley Pingree says the workers can apply for the Trade Adjustment Assistance Program. It helps workers who have lost their jobs because of foreign competition. Benefits include a health coverage tax credit, a job search allowance, and tuition assistance as well.
Man convicted of capital murder, the death of a Manchester, New Hampshire police officer, getting ready to face the state Supreme Court. Today, judges will hear oral arguments in Michael Addison's appeal. In 2008, a jury convicted Addison of shooting and killing officer Michael Briggs. Now, the case was the first death sentence handed down in New Hampshire in more than 50 years. The Obama administration Secretary of the Interior will be in Boston today to announce whether he'll approve the nation's first offshore wind farm. Now, the 130-turbine Cape Wind project will be located in Nantucket Sound off of Cape Cod. Governor Deval Patrick, who supports the project, will join Secretary Ken Salazar for the announcement. Cape Wind project has been under review now for 9 years. A little girl was the guest of honor at a huge celebration in Hollis.
And what a story this is. An assembly was held at Hollis Elementary School for 7-year-old Emma Coldwell. Now, back on March 13th, Emma's mom, Lori, was making dinner when she passed out and then fell on the floor. Emma quickly picked up the phone and then called for help, something that helped save her mother's life since she suffered a stroke. Because of her quick thinking, the Hollis rescue team presented her with a plaque yesterday.
Children need to know what to do in an emergency, whether it's a fire or a medical emergency. They really need to know who to call and when to call.
It's nice to see her recognized for something that was the responsible thing to do, but not only responsible. It was, you know, like it was said more than once, it was life or death.
And because of Emma's efforts, her mother received the care that she needed for her stroke in a timely manner and is said to be doing very well. What a great story. Great ending there.
Absolutely.
That's it for this update. I'm Norm Karkos.
And I'm Shannon Moss. Stay with us. We're going to bring the latest forecasts and sports highlights in just a few minutes. We'll be right back.